Hello everyone, a very good afternoon to all of you. This is going to be the third part of the poem Keeping Quiet. As far we study about the necessity of quiet introspection and how we can create the feeling of mutual understanding among the human beings. First, the poet tells us about the process by which we can attain total self-introspection. And after that, the poet tells us about the consequences or the impact of quiet introspection on human society. Students, let me tell you, the last stanza of the poem is all about optimism. How we can come out through the direst stress, tension, worry, and how we can justify ourselves on the planet that we are a worthy human being. So, let's see the fourth, the last stanza of the poem is perhaps the earth can teach us. What? See, perhaps the earth can teach us as when everything seems dead. As when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. Now I will count up to 12. And you keep quiet. And I will go. Okay, see, perhaps the earth can teach us, as I earlier mentioned right now, that it is about the optimism. To create the optimism in human being, the poet says that even though the nature can teach us a lesson, even though the earth can teach us a lesson, earth or nature can teach us a lesson, what type of lesson the earth can teach us? The earth can teach us how we can live our life smoothly on the planet. You know, in the apparent stillness, there is tranquility. In apparent stillness, there can be apparent, tranquility. And the same thing is mentioned here. When everything seems dead, you know, in the throughout the year, there are so many seasons. Among them, in autumn, you see the flowers fell down from the trees. And later in the spring season, everything blooms. Later in the spring season. So, what happens? The poet says that perhaps the earth can teach us, even though here earth is a living organism, but still it is personified because it is being said that it can teach us. So, we can say here in this line there is personification plus being. Personification. आपको साथ के साथ figure of speech देखने हैं. Perhaps the earth can teach us. धरती हमें सिखा सकती है, पढ़ा सकती है. What? That in the time of direst stress you have to be very optimistic. What happened that many times in human lifespan you see feeling with sadness, frustration. So what? The earth can provide the example that throughout the year there may be the time when everything seems dead, but later it proves to be alive. But later it proves to be alive. धरती हमें सिखा सकती है, पढ़ा सकती है कि apparent stillness में भी हमें जो है कुछ न कुछ optimistic मिल सकता है. You know, जब प्रकृति में सब कुछ समाप्त हो जाता है, तो बाद में फिर भी ये सजीव हो जाती है, जागरूक हो जाती है, अपने आप में एक तरीके से एक नई ऊर्जा के साथ सामने आती है। धरती की बात की गई है, नेचर की बात की गई है, प्रकृति के रूटीन की बात की गई है, वो कभी भी अपने पथ से अलग नहीं भटकते, नहीं होते प्रकृति की जितनी भी ऑब्जेक्ट है वो। एंड लेटर प्रूव्स टू बी अलाइव। सो इन द सेम वे द पॉइंट्स वांट्स टू कन्वे अ वेरी सिंपल मैसेज टू द ह्यूमन बीइंग दैट यू कैन टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ द अर्थ, यू कैन टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ द नेचर वेयर अपॉन एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग सिस्टमेटिकली। ओके, समटाइम्स व्हाट हैपन, देयर इज ट्रैंक्विलिटी इन अपॉन स्टिलनेस एज वेल, देयर इज ट्रैंक्विलिटी इन द अपॉन स्टिलनेस, एंड द सेम थिंग कैन be learned from the earth, because throughout the season several times we came to know that it seems to be very dead, but later on the earth becomes very full of life. So in the same way human beings sometimes find frustrated, sometimes find conflicted of different types, but if we take the example of the nature we can remain, you know, in a very optimistic way. Now the poet wants to say, I will count up to 12. Now, I will start to the process of quiet introspection. Now, it is the high time to remain silent. It is the time we have to start the process of quiet introspection. Now, I will try to count up to 12. 12 is very significant word, as I earlier mentioned that it is the time, short spend time. Okay, short spend time. And in the short spend time, we have to start quiet introspection. You keep quiet. The point urges to the readers, the humility, that please be silent and take a little bit of time for quiet introspection. And I will certainly go, means I will certainly be with you with the process of quiet introspection to create the feeling of mutual understanding among the human society. So, in these lines, the poet gives the example of the nature or the earth, that we can learn a strong lesson from the earth or the nature, that in disciplined manner we can create optimism in our life. Sometimes what happens that seems everything seems deadly, but later on it proves to be very fruitful. So we have to be optimistic throughout the life. And what we have to do now is counting up to 12, or we have to start our process of quiet introspection, and if you saw, it creates the mutual understanding in the human society. So, students, you know, this is the stanza, the last stanza, whereupon the poet gives the example of nature, that how we can create the feeling of mutual understanding among the human society. So, now I would like to tell you the questions related to the poem, and later on, definitely, we go through all the important figure of speeches as well in the poem, because there are so many images involved in this poem. So your question is, what will, see, what will counting 12 will help us achieve? What will counting 12 will help us achieve? What would happen to count to 12? You know, 12 is a short span of time. The poet wants to say that if you go through for your own introspective way for a little bit of time, you remain in introspection for a little bit of time, it may create the feeling of mutual understanding among the human society. The poet wants to say the counting up to 12 mean that you have to take a little bit of time, to spare a little bit of time, and whereupon you have to remain very silent, think about your own work or what you have to do in your upcoming time, start a new beginning. That's why it will help us to achieve harmony in the society. It will achieve to create the harmony in the society. It will give us, you know, the complete protection from direst stress. Take the next question here on. Do you think, see, do you think the poet advocates Do you think the poet advocates total inactivity? Total inactivity and death. Do you think the poet advocates total inactivity and death? Certainly not. The poet says that what I mean to say doesn't be confused. I doesn't want to be in the mode of total inactivity. I have no track with that. He very clearly mentioned that to remain silent doesn't mean to be sit idly. To remain silent doesn't mean to create the feeling of inactivity. No, the poet wants to say that it is only a short span of time where you can look forward in your upcoming difficulties, upcoming time. So the poet doesn't advocate total inactivity. Rather, he wants to say a simple thing that for a little bit of time they remain to be very silent and they have to be in the mode whereupon they can look forward in their about their upcoming time. So poet doesn't advocate total inactivity. He is only with the fruitful aspect or positive aspect of life. Next question. What does the poet say? What does the poet say about different kinds of power? Different kind of wars. The poet mentions several kind of war. One of them is the war against environment. In the name of development, people destroy or spoil the forest each and every day. So this is the war against environment. He also mentions the war against war of destructive weapons or poisonous gases, war of poisonous gases to destroy the human society. The poet is very fearful about these type of wars. This, what type of war he mentions in the poem? The war against environment, green war. He talks a lot about green war, war with gases and wars with fire. So these type of war only can bring the total destruction of the human society rather than anything else. And they want that there should be the victory without any survivors. The poet strongly opposed the idea of having such type of opinion in the dominant people of the society. So these are the type of war he mentioned in the poem. We have mentioned all these type of war. What is the exotic moment? What is the exotic moment the poet wishes for? Exotic moment kya hai jiske bare mein kavi jo hai baat karta hai? Exotic moment is the moment where the people on the planet may start the process of quiet introspection. It is related to the moment, unusual moment. When they start the process of quiet introspection, at that time the people remain silent across the world, and that would be the exotic moment whereupon there would be no hurry, worry, tension in the world, and everyone be in the good wishes for each other, and there should be no thought or competition with each other. So the poet wishes to be a very healthy environment in the society. And that's why the exact time where the process of quiet introspection begins, the exotic moment is being taken from there. So the exotic moment is the unusual moment, and it provides the mutual understanding in the society. It provides the tranquility in the nature. Okay, total tranquility in the nature. ओके, व्हाट इंपॉर्टेंट लेसन कैन अर्थ कैन टीच अस, अर्थ हमें क्या सिखा सकता है, अर्थ से हमें क्या शिक्षा मिलती। अभी लास्ट स्टेंजा में हमने देखा था कि अर्थ कैन टीच अस ए लेसन एंड इन अपार्ट स्टिलनेस देयर कैन बी अ लाइफ, द अर्थ कैन टीच अस दैट इन अपार्ट स्टिलनेस देयर कैन बी अ लाइफ, इन ऑप्टिमिस्टिक वे इफ यू सर्वाइव इफ यू लिव देन देयर वुड बी अ टाइम व्हेन यू फाइंड योरसेल्फ समथिंग फ्रूटफुल और पॉजिटिव बिकॉज इट इज द पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ लाइफ, फियर स्ट्रेस इट मे बी नॉट लिंगर ऑन within the time limit. So the time may come where you have to look forward in the time of distress, tension and worry. So earth can teach us the discipline or how we can live our life fruitfully. Okay, these are the questions. So dear students, now I would like to tell you few of the figure speeches, most important figure speeches involved in the poem. It's significantly important from the point of view of exam, the figure of speeches. You know, there are several figure of speeches in the poem. Let's see, there are so many images. You have to understand the figure of speeches, we will, and the same type of his her hands. Okay, and apart from one song, and clean clothes. Figure of speech, you may understand alliteration. जितने भी parts हैं, phrases हैं, चाहे वो sentences है, we live है, his hurt hands है, चोटिल हाथों के लिए, one song है, clean clothes है, तो इन सभी में आपका there is a figure of speech of alliteration. Without rust, without engines. Without rust, without engines. A repetition. Without, without. Fishermen. Fishermen in the cold sea would not harm whales. इस दो फ्रेज है, ये जो स्ट्रेंजर की जो लाइन है इसमें इमेजेस हैं. You can say the whole, if you write down the complete sentence of the stanza, third stanza, fishermen in the cold sea would not hurt the whales in cold sea. So fishermen here is the dominant people, the image of dominant people, and whale here is the oppressed people. So there is images through the characters of fishermen and whales. So it is imagery. After that, cold sea. Transferred epithet. Transferred epithet. Transferred epithet मतलब एडजेक्टिव नाउन को क्वालिफाई करें तो उसमें आपका ट्रांसफर्ड epithet. Look forward for some more figure of speeches involved in the poem. Put on clean clothes. Metaphor. Put on clean clothes. Metaphor. Here there is a word brothers. Brothers is actually, you know, a symbol. ये एक सिंबल है mankind का. Okay, in the said metaphor. In the said metaphor. No trap. It is euphemism. NP was statement in soft way. कोई भी बात सॉफ्ट वे में स्ट्रॉन्ग चीज स्किल कही जाए इन ए वेरी सॉफ्ट मैनर देर इज ए स्ट्रॉन्ग मैसेज एंड दिस इज द मैसेज ऑफ एंटी वार सो इट इज यूफेमिज्म यूफेमिज्म एंड पर्हैप्स द अर्थ कैन टीच अस पर्हैप्स द अर्थ कैन टीच अस पर्सोनिफिकेशन The earth is being personified. So these are the figure of speeches involved in the poem. Okay.